Dear students, welcome to virtual class of Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai. I am Sri Kumar. The class is for 7th standard students. Subject is mathematics. Let me begin the class.
Dear students, this is a revision of your first lesson regarding the construction of angle bisector, perpendicular bisector. Thereafter, how to find out the point of concurrence of angle bisector of a triangle as well as perpendicular bisector of a triangle. Moreover, you will be getting idea about how to draw or construct triangles. So you have already done. This is a quick revision of that chapter.
To recollect what you have learned in the previous year. First one is about angle bisector, then again perpendicular bisector of line segment. So let me show you how angle bisector is done. Last year it is taught. For that I need to have an angle first. To draw an angle I need a ruler first. So this is a ruler. I am going to draw a simple angle over here. To draw an angle you need a simple angle here. Okay, take the ruler and keep the ruler in the other side and draw an angle here. We are going to have an angle bisector. Angle bisector ka matlab kya hai? Angle ban gaya abhi. Ye angle banne ke baad ye angle tabhi aayega. Idhar ek arrow mark, another arrow mark. Aur mera kaam ye hai ki idhar likhna hai drawing angle bisector. Chalo angle bisector draw karenge. Now to draw angle bisector I should first of all I can name this angle if required. The angle can be named as kya naam de dun. Now angle can be named as angle angle ABC. A B C. Angle ABC नाम डाला. अगर एंगल ए बी सी नाम डाला तो इधर भी नाम डालना है. ए अदर टेक्स विल बी बी तो अदर आर्म विल बी सी. नाउ टू ड्रॉ एंगल बाइसेक्टर वी नीड कॉम्बस. दिस इज अ कॉम्बस. बहुत बड़ा कॉम्बस है. The compass is quite big. We'll make the compass small so that apne haath mein baithe. And we need to, this is something which I have learned, so I am going fast without much explanation. We need to have what we say compass. We will be drawing an arc over here of our own measurement. There is no any strict rule. You can draw an arc here, turn the compass, another arc here. Take the compass from there, keep it at that point where arc is intersecting the arm of the angle. Little expand it if possible. Not, don't draw it. Simply you have to expand it a little bit so that you can get the arc little bit convenient location. Draw the second arc here, I mean of the same, without disturbing. Take the compass and keep here. ये आपके compass जैसा नहीं है, special compass है ना, virtual compass. Draw it here, keep the compass aside, bring the ruler. We can name this particular intersection with a, we can give a name. Let it go. There is an intersection made which we can name it as X. So a line from B to X through that point will be the angle bisector. So we need name for each point in geometry. This is geometry. Geometry is a branch of mathematics where you will be dealing about this kind of shape, measurement, size, etc., which is a very important aspect and which will be talking to you about logical reasoning also, because there is a concept of proof and statement in geometry. Okay, we have kept the ruler almost correct. Bear with me, why? Because these are all digital ruler and all. I need to draw the bisector, the demanded bisector now. This is the bisector passing through that particular point. So this way I can make an angle bisector, which tells that the line drawn is dividing the angle into two equal halves. That is what is the concept of angle bisector. The angle bisector is BX here. You need to repeat this means repeat the video so that it can be fixed properly in your mind. This is something which you have learned earlier. So the next one is constructing a perpendicular bisector of a line segment. Let me write over here, perpendicular bisector of a line segment. All these words are important. Perpendicular means 90 degree to the given line. By means two, sector is dividing. And what is divided here? A line segment. So for that I need a line segment first. So I should draw a line segment with the help of a ruler. This is the line segment I am drawing. And after drawing line segment, we are supposed to name it. I would like to give the name AB to this line segment. Let the line segment be AB. Line segment AB, we are going to divide. In order to divide that with another line perpendicular to it, I need compass. This is the compass, a digital virtual compass it is. I will make it little smaller for the easiness of maneuvering here, drawing easy. Keep one end of the pointer of the compass at A, in this case. Expand it in such a way that it is more than half of the given line segment. Then you have to draw arc in such a way that, I'll show you now something need to be shown to you. Drawing an arc on up and down of the given line segment in this manner, one arc is drawn without disturbing the pointer of the compass. Draw an arc here also. Draw a little big so that our work is done properly. Keep the compass on the other end of the line segment. Bring the compass in such a way that we have to draw another arc intersecting the already drawn arc. See, in this way, without disturbing, take to the other side. Draw the arc over here. Now we know that we have drawn four arcs, two pairs. We have got a point of intersection of the arcs. And these points are to be marked now, which can be marked X and Y. Now, the perpendicular, which is demanded from us, which we are drawing, is the perpendicular bisector will be the line connecting these two points. For that, we should bring the scale here, I mean the ruler, in such a way that the points will be connected with the help of a line . Okay, I have kept the ruler perfectly. Now I need to draw a line through these two points with care. Okay, line is drawn. This particular line is a perpendicular bisector of the given line segment AB. We can check it with the help of our ruler and to feel that is it okay. It is almost 3.5. Here also it is 3.5, which tells us that this particular line is the perpendicular bisector of the given line segment. Put arrow mark on both end to show that it is a line. So my dear student, this you have done already in previous years. This was a revision or recalling of it in order to make you understand how further construction is done in this case. Okay. Let us go ahead to see that what more we should learn in this chapter. The next one is the property of angle bisector, which tells us that we know that how to draw angle bisector now. We have already done it. If you draw angle bisector of a triangle, there are three angles for a triangle. The angle bisectors are concurrent, concurrent. Here in this case, there is a point I, which is the concurrence point in this case. Secondly, if you draw perpendicular from that point to each side of the triangle, here it is from I to A, I to C, and I to B, then these perpendiculars will be of equal length. This activity you have to do yourself in the book. I will be showing it once now here, but it won't help you much because you have to do. So here, the property of the angle bisector of a triangle, which we are trying to understand. For that, you need a triangle first. I can get a triangle from here. Let this be the triangle, a convenient triangle. Let me name the triangle. The triangle be PQR. PQR is the triangle. Now we have to draw the angle bisector. Now you know how to draw the angle bisector. I will just start drawing it because we have already got an idea about how to draw angle bisector. All depends upon the accuracy of how we are drawing. We need to have a very sharp pencil, sharp compass, everything so that the diagram comes out splendidly. An angle bisector can be drawn by drawing arc in this way. You have already just learned. You'll have arc on all the three angles over here. For my convenience, I have to shift the compass here and there, one angle here, one arc here, not angle, another arc here, take the compass from there, rotate the compass, because we are doing it on a two-dimensional surface, not like your physical compass. An arc over here, again take the compass here. An arc over here. I completed first round of arc drawing. Okay, take the compass away. And now in the second round, you have to, for convenience, as I told you before, you will be just increasing the size of the compass. Expand it a little bit so that it will be convenient for us. And bring the compass to the point of intersection of arc on the sides of the triangle where it is intersecting, and you need to draw again arc over there. keep the compass at that point where the arc is intersecting on the sides, then again you have to draw arc, take the compass to the other side. Other side means other side of the triangle, and rotate it in such a way that you get an intersection of arc. The compass should be kept at the point of intersection of arc with the other side. Okay, if you make the compass a little more expanded, you will get a little bit of more clear. Expanding now is also not a problem because these all are different angles and different expansion will help me in such a way that so that I can differentiate. Even color will help me to differentiate the different arcs. That you cannot do. You will be having pencil at the tip at the end of your compass. Okay, another arc over here. I just expanded it for my convenience of getting the point of intersection correctly, or it can be visible to me. Now taking to the third, where I think it will be better if I make it a little smaller and rotate the compass for my convenience, changing the color for identification and rotate it conveniently. Okay, another arc here and keep the compass here carefully. And complete the arc. So we have done the formation of arc from all the three angles. I need to little go fast, and I will be using some technique to draw now. This is the way by which I can draw an arc or bisector, which we have already studied, from the point Q through the intercept of arcs. And the same way other side, let me put it directly to it without scale, okay, through the other arc. Then in the case of third case, all three V's are meeting at a point. Now the thing is that this point where it is meeting, that is a point of concurrence, we call it as. And we are supposed to draw perpendicular from that point. To draw perpendicular from that point, we will be using protractor. Then protractor will help us. This is the protractor. The protractor will be brought over here. We'll get an idea about the perpendicular position and other. Almost that bisector itself is perpendicular, so I will make a drawing over that directly. Another perpendicular to be drawn from other side, because in the almost location of problem, we have to turn it such a way that it sits properly. I have to shift it a little. Okay, I have shifted it almost correctly. Then here also I have to draw a perpendicular through that 90 degree of that protractor. Again, another perpendicular to be drawn from the other side of the triangle. Okay, so another perpendicular is drawn. हमारे आंखों में नहीं बैठे बट इट इज परपेंडिकुलर नाउ विद इज परपेंडिकुलर्स फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्करेंस टू द पॉइंट ऑन द साइड्स ऑफ द ट्राइंगल वी हैव टू मेजर इट दे आर परपेंडिकुलर आई विल बी जस्ट शोइंग द सेम लोगो फॉर शोइंग दैट परपेंडिकुलर एट द सेम टाइम वी हैव टू नेम दोस पॉइंट्स A, B, C, and the center part can be named as I, and we know that the length of IA, that is what is our conclusion, here is I, the length IA, not small letter, IA must be equal to IB, must be equal to IC. This is what is the conclusion. Let me remove this protractor from here. So in this way, we can prove that your test book is saying that the IA, IB, IC are congruent. The lines, the bisector lines will be meeting at a point which is called, they are concurrent. This is what is one aspect you have to understand regarding the properties of angle bisectors in a triangle. Okay. Now click on the subscription button below to subscribe the channel, then the bell button to get the notifications of the new videos. Thank you. Now click on the subscription button below to subscribe the channel, then the bell button to get the notifications of the new videos. Thank you.